The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 11, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 30th of June, 1973, in Calcutta, India.
Translation: Fools deride me when I descend in the human form. They do not know my transcendental nature and my supreme dominion over all that be.
Krishna is not an ordinary man. Therefore, Krishna warns this. Avajananti mang murha. Murha rascals. To accept God as man and to accept man as God, this is rascals. Rascaldom means to accept a man as God and to accept God as man. This is rascaldom. Avajananti mana mura. We can understand who is an intelligent man and who is a rascal by this criteria. In another place, Krishna says, Namang duskitinam murha parpadante naradhama. Murha, rascals, they do not surrender unto me. Krishna is canvassing, especially in India, he appeared. He is canvassing, sarvadharman parityajya, mamekam saranam bhavi. He is canvassing. But the murhas, they will not accept it. Avajananti mana murha. Oh, why shall I accept Krishna? I have got my own God. I manufacture my God. So, we have got very shortcut criterion to understand a rascal and intelligent. What is that? If he is a devotee of Krishna, then he is intelligent. If he is not, then he is rascal. That's all. No, he does not accept Krishna as God, but he has many other gods, especially in our Hindu society. They say, the Mahabharat philosophers, they say that everyone is God. How everyone can be God? If everyone is God, then what is the significance of God? Even not demigods. In the Shastra says, just to Narayanam Devam Brahma Rudradi Daivati. Not to speak of ordinary demigods, but big, big demigods, just like Brahma, Lord Shiva, even Vishnu. Of course, Krishna is Vishnu Tattva. Krishna is not in the category of Jiva Tattva. There are Jiva Tattvas, there are Shakti Tattvas, there are Vishnu Tattvas. People do not know it. Therefore, in the next line it is said, Param Bhavam Ajananta. They do not know what is Vishnu Tattva, what is Jiva Tattva, what is Shakti Tattva, how things are working. Param Bhavam Ajananta. Mama Bhutam Maheshwaram. I am the Supreme Person. In another place Krishna says, Matta Parataram Nanyat. There is no more superior personality than this. These are the facts. In the Brahma Sanghita, it is said, Ishara Parama Krishna. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. You can become God. I can become God. He can become God. But Supreme God is Krishna. If you accept that we are all gods, but still there is distinction. There is male God, there is female God, there is child God, there is educated God, there is foolish God. If we are all gods, then you have to qualify these gods in this way. There are differentiation from one God to another. That means one God is superior than the another God. That you have to accept. In this way, if you go on making progress, who is the best God? Then you come to Krishna. Ishara Parama Krishna. Satchidananda Vigraha. Satchidananda Vigraha. So, the Param, Parabrahma, impersonal, they say. No. Vigraha, person, just like you and me. Person. But they cannot imagine how a person can become so powerful, as in the previous verse it is said, Maya dhakshena prakriti shriyate sa characharam. A person is directing, just like we direct. A big businessman is sitting in his room alone, but he is directing the whole factory, whole business, everything that is being done. Although Krishna is Goloka Vrindavan, he has nothing to do. Why God has something to do? Then what kind of God he is? Here we see practically a big man, a big minister, a big prime minister or president. He is also sitting, giving direction. He has nothing to do. Similarly, Krishna also, he has nothing to do. Krishna is enjoying. Just like you see Krishna's form, he's enjoying Srimati Radhara. He has nothing to do. That is confirmed in the Vedic literature. Natasakajam karanancha vidyati. Why God should be busy doing something? So param bhava vajan. They do not know what is God. Although God is appearing before them, we have got the name of God, the fame of God, the pastimes of God, the demonstration of His different energies of God, everything is there. Still we are searching after God, and unfortunately we are manifesting a man-God. Therefore we are murhas. Avajananti maga murha. Here is God, accepted by all acharyas, not that by sentiment. There are acharyas in India. Practically our whole civilization is guided by the acharyas. Acharya man purusha veda. We have to accept acharya. In India, our culture, Vedic culture, depending on acharyas. Even we differ, we Vaishnavas. There are Vaishnavas acharyas. And there is Mahavadi Acharya. So Shankaracharya is Mahavadi, impersonalist. Still he accepts Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sa Bhagavan Sayang Krishna, Devaki Navya. He has written in his commentary on the Bhagavad Gita. He accepts Narayana Parah Abhaktya, Sa Bhagavan Narayana Krishna. He has accepted. And what to speak of Ramanacharya, Madhyacharya and other acharyas. Latest acharya Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 500 years. These acharyas are thousands of years ago. They appeared, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared about 500 years ago. He accepted Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And we are followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Acharyavan Purusha Veda. One who is Acharyavan, one is following Acharya, he knows things as they are. Acharyavan Purusha Veda. So unless we become Acharyavan, that is the Vedic instruction. Tad vijnanartham sa guru meva abhigacchet. We cannot understand God. What is God? We cannot make research. We do not know what are the symptoms of God. Although everything is described in the shastras, here also in the Bhagavad Gita, the indications are there. Matta parataram nanya. There is nobody superior than me. So, this is the shortcut definition of God. Just try to find out a person. God is also a person. But he is the most superior person. Nitya Nityanam Chaitana Chaitananam. He is the chief amongst the living beings. Nitya Nityanam. He is the wisest of all wise men. Chaitana Chaitananam. Now what is the difference between God and us? The difference is that He is the maintainer and we are maintained. This is the difference. We are not maintainer. Nobody can say, one can say that I am God, but nobody can say that I am maintaining everyone. No, that is not possible. This is the simple definition of God, given in the Vedic literature. Eka jo bahunam vidhati kama. We have necessities of life, but who is supplying the necessities of life? That eka, that one person, eka. So, it is a great science to understand God. It is not an ordinary thing, simply by speculation or by so-called meditation, you become God. God is God, always. You cannot become God if you are not God. Krishna was God when he was 3 months old on the lap of his mother. Krishna was God when he was 4 months old. Krishna was God when he was 7 years old. Now we are chanting, Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari Gopi Jana Vallava Girivaradhari. Krishna was Gopi Jana Vallava. He was always meant for pleasing the gopis. But that does not mean that he was not God. Girivaradhari. When gopis were in danger, incessant rain in Vrindavan, he immediately lifted the whole Govardhan Parvat. Immediately said, here is, I am God. I can give you protection. Girivaradhari. One side Gopijana Vallava, just like ordinary boy, he is pleasing the gopis by his joking behavior. But that does not mean he is not God. So one imitates the joking behavior of Krishna, but one cannot imitate lifting the Govardhan heel. That is not possible. Therefore, those who are murhas, they deride at Krishna. They cannot believe how a person can become the supreme authority. Otherwise, one who knows the Buddha Bhava Samannita, Aham Sarvasya Prabhava Matta Sarvam Pravartate Iti Matya Bhajanti Imam Buddha Bhava Samannita. Those who are Buddhas, they are Krishna conscious. They are devotees of Krishna. Krishna je bhaje sevaro chotu. Without being very, very intelligent, nobody can become Krishna conscious, devotee of Krishna. These murhas cannot become. It is not possible. If you want to remain a murha, then you cannot understand. When your murhattam, your anwisdom will go, how it will go? Bhavanam janmanamanti jnanavan maang prapadrat. If you cultivate knowledge, spiritual knowledge, for many, many births, Bahunam, because he will not accept Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead simply by saying, by Krishna. Krishna says, yes, I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If you don't believe it, then you have to cultivate knowledge for many, many births. You have to take birth and cultivate spiritual knowledge, again die, again come, again take birth. This will go on continuously. Bahunam janmanamanti. And if you are fortunate enough to become wise enough, then you will understand Vasudeva Sarvamiti, Samahatma. Vasudeva Krishna is everything. That is confirmed in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Vasudeva Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Janayati Asu Vairagyam Jnananca Jad Ahitakam. If you become devotee of Vasudeva, Bhaja Vasudeva, then very quickly, you will become Jnanavan. First of all, one becomes Jnanavan, then he surrenders to Vasudeva. Sarvadharman parityaja mamekam saranam. This is one process. Another process is, you become a devotee of Vasudeva, then Gyan Vairagya will automatically come. Because the human life, the perfection of human life is to accept Gyan and Vairagya. That is perfect. In our Vedic civilization, this is the process, perfection. There are different stages of life. Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyas. So what is the Sannyas law? Sannyas means perfection, Gyan and Vairagya. Who can take Sannyas? Renounce order. Unless he has got full knowledge, as Shankaracharya explains, Brahma Satya Jagan Mitya. Unless one understands fully that our these material engagements, they are simply waste of time. He can attain perfection knowledge. Jnana Vairagya Juktaya. Unless there is perfection of knowledge, Jnana, there cannot be Vairagya. And unless there is Vairagya, unless he becomes distasteful of this material existence, there is no question of liberation. Jnana Vairagya Juktaya. So this Jnana and Vairagya can be achieved simply by becoming a devotee of Vasudeva. That is the verdict of Srimad Bhagavatam. Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayodita Janayati Asubairagya. Very soon, just like this boy, these American, these European boys, they're young men. Now they have taken sannyas and dedicated their life for service of Krishna. They are Vairagya. They are coming from opulent nation, very rich nation. Their parents are very rich. There is no scarcity of food. There is no scarcity of money. There is no scarcity of women in the Western countries. But they have left everything. Simply boys. They are all within 30. How much a young man may have propensities for enjoying this material way of life, and when there is facilities, but how they have taken to it. This is the proof. Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayajita Janayati Asubairagya Jnananti Jadavi. This is proof. So actually, if we want Jnan and knowledge, because human life is meant for Jnan and knowledge, human life is not meant for living like animals, cats and dogs. Cats and dogs cannot be elevated to the platform of Jnana and Vairagya. That is not possible. A human being can be elevated by education, by culture, to the platform of Jnana and Vairagya. That is the ultimate goal. See, Narottam Das Thakur sings therefore, Hari Hari Bhiphale Janama Gwain. Manusya janama paiya radha krishna nabhariya janiya suniya bishok khain. This is Gyan. Regret. My dear Lord, I got this very opportune moment to possess this human form of life. Manusya janama paiya. But my duty was to worship radha krishna. That is the highest perfection of worship. Ramya Kajit Upasana Brajabadhu Varga Vija Kalpita. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommended. The Upasana, the worship, which was invented by the gopis to worship Radha and Krishna. Ramya Kajit Upasana. There is no more perfect Upasana. So, this Radha Krishna Upasana is the perfection of Upasana. Even it is better than Vishnu Upasana. In the material way of life, Vishnu Upasana has been recommended at the highest. Aradhananam param devi, Vishnu aradhanam param. It is the statement of Lord Shiva to Parvati. That of all aradhan, Vishnu aradhan is the best. Aradhananam sarvesham Vishnu aradhanam param. Tasmat paratanam devi tadyanam aradhan. Tasmat paratanam, even better than Vishnu aradhana, is to worship the Vaishnava. Madhvaktya puja bhadika. Krishna has said also, anyone who is worshipping my devotee, pure devotee, that is better worship than one who is worshipping me directly. So, Sri Narottam Das Thakur says that I got this opportunity of human life, but instead of worshipping Radha Krishna, I worship so many things. Somebody is worshipping his body, somebody is worshipping his mind, somebody is worshipping his country, somebody is worshipping his something else, or somebody is worshipping some other demigods also. But that is not recommended in the Shastra, at least in the Bhagavad Gita. Kamastakta hitajnana jajanti anna devata. There are worshippers of other demigods, but they have been described in the Bhagavad Gita as hitajnana. Hitajnana, Sri Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur comments, nashtabuddhaya, one who has lost his intelligence. These are the bhajis of the Shastra. Therefore, one who has taken only to Krishna worship, sarvadhanmahan paritajyamami tam, only Krishna, he is intelligent. And one is not intelligent, murha, he does not take. This is straight meaning of Bhagavad Gita. You can make your own meaning. But if you want to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is, this is the meaning. You cannot accept the worship even of big, big demigods. What to speak of minor demigods, even big demigods just like Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva. You can worship. Vaishnava is ready to give respect even to the ant. And why not Lord Shiva? And why not Lord Brahma or any other demigods? They offer. But they offer in which way? As servant of Krishna. Just like in the Brahma Sangita, there is Sisti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Sakti Rika Chaiva Jasa Bhuvanani Vibhakti Durga. This is worship of Durga. The Vaishnava, Brahma, is offering respect to Mother Durga. So similarly, a Vaishnava never disrespects any demigod. Why demigods? They are so exalted. They do not disrespect even an ant. Tinadupi sunitena, tarorupi sahishnuna, omanina manade. A Vaishnava should be ready to give respect to anyone, all living entities, because all living entities are part and parcel of Krishna. They should offer respect to everyone. Just like this finger is my part and parcel of the body. If you respect my body and cut my finger, shall I be happy? No. Therefore, Vaishnava knows this, that even a small ant, he is the part and parcel of Krishna. So if I kill this ant, Krishna will be unhappy. Krishna will be unhappy. There was a bat in the Padma Purana. The story is there. He was habituated to kill animals. Bat, you know, hunter. So he was killing so many animals half dead. So Narad Muni was passing through that forest. He was pretty much agreed. Who is this rascal killing these animals half? And they are flapping out of painful condition. Let me see this rascal. So he searched out this bad hunter. The bad was very busy in his hunting. So he thought, because after all, Narad Muni is a Vaishnava. After seeing him personally, his heart was immediately little clarified. So he offered respect. Sir, you have come here for some tiger skin or deer skin, I shall give it. But don't disturb in my business. Please let me do my business. So Narad Muni said, all right, you do your business, but one thing I request, why you are not killing these animals all at a time? Why you are killing half? It is great sin. Then it stuck to his brain. Sin? What is this sin? Then he described the effects of sin. Then he said, I have been taught by my father to do this business. So if I do not do this business, how shall I live? So Narad Muni said, if I guarantee your living, would you give me up this business, this profession? So why not? If I give my living means, then I can give up. So it was agreed that he will give up his business of hunting. And Narad Muni said that I will give you all necessities of your life. Come on. So, it is a long story, I am making shortcut. So Narad Muni asked him that he sit down on this bank of Ganges. And here is the tulsi plant. You worship it and I will send your food. Don't be worried. So next morning it was declared in the village that heinous hunter has become a Vaishnava. So people generally, they are inquisitive. They came to see. It is the custom. When you go to see a saintly person, you take some fruits or flowers or some rice or some atta. So huge sack of rice and atta and fruits and flowers. They were surprised. Why Narad Muni is sending so much? We are simply husband and wife. In this way, they become Vaishnava. And after some time, Narad Muni with his friend Parvat Muni, he wanted to see his devotee. So he asked Parvat Muni that, my dear friend, will you come with me? I shall show my devotee who was formerly a hunter. So Parvat Muni knew that you can play wonderful. So let me see this devotee. So when Narad Muni was coming, this devotee was going to receive the spiritual master. This is the custom, to receive the spiritual master from distant place with all honor by bowing down. But he was jumping. He was jumping. So when he came near, the Parvat Muni first of all asked him, my dear son, you are a great devotee, but while coming here, why you are jumping? He said that on the ground there are so many ants. So I do not want to kill these ants. This is the effect of devotional service. The same man who was taking pleasure by killing one animal half dead, he is not prepared to kill even an ant. This is called bhakti. Deshasi bhakti bhagavati akinchana sarvai dunai tatra samasate sura. If one becomes a devotee of the Lord, akinchana bhakti, then sarvai gunai, all good qualities will come out automatically. Because every living entity is part and parcel of God. God is all good. Therefore, every living entity, potentially, constitutionally, he is also good. As God is good, we are also good. But due to our material association, we have become bad. So if we revive our old position, Krishna consciousness, then automatically we shall become all good. This is Krishna consciousness movement. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has recommended that, oh, Cheta Dharpana Marjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nidvapana. If you want to see, to stop this blazing fire of material existence, then you have to spread this Krishna consciousness movement all over the world. And the practical effect, you can see what is already done, how they have become. There are limitations. We cannot accept anyone and everyone as disciple unless he agrees tacitly to give up some preliminary principles. Just like illicit sex life, anyone who comes to me to become my disciple, the first condition is no illicit sex life, no intoxication. After drinking, smoking, or even drinking tea and coffee and chewing pan. These are also intoxicants. So one cannot take all these things. No intoxication, no illicit sex. Unless you have got connection with woman by marriage ties, there cannot be any sex life. These are the pillars of sinful life. Jatra papas chaturvidha. Striyasuna pana dhuto jatra papas chaturvidha. If you actually want to make progress in spiritual life, you must accept at least these four principles. This is tapasya. Tapasya brahmacharyena, tyagena, shauchas, sattam, satta shauchabhyam, These are the prescriptions. So, to become purified, one must be purified of this material existence. Then he can understand what is God. Then he can serve God. With this material senses, it is not possible to serve God. That is not possible. Atah Sri Krishna Namani Namave Grayam Indriyai. These indriyas, the present indriyas, contaminated by material existence, you cannot understand by simply hearing about God. Therefore, you have to purify yourself. Sarvapadi vinirmuktam tatparatena nirmalam. This is the definition given by Narad Muni. How one can become a devotee? How one can be engaged in the devotional service of the Lord? This is the formula. What is that? Sarvapadi vinirmuktam. First condition. One has to give up all designation. I am Indian, I am American, I am Brahmana, I am Sudra, I am this and that. These are all designations of the body, but we are not this body. So, if we can give up this bodily designation, that is called Sarvapadi Vinirmuktam. Sarvapadi Vinirmuktam. Tatparatena Nirmala. Then one has to become purified on the standard of devotional service. Unless one is engaged in devotional service, there is no question of purification. Then he will fall down. These are the statements in the shastras. Arujya krichena param padam tata patanti adha. You can elevate yourself to the Brahma effulgence, Brahma jnana. Arujya krichena, with tapasya, with severe austerities. But if you cannot understand Krishna, if you do not take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, then he will again fall down. Arujya krichena paranga pada tata patanti adha anadhita jusmat angraya. So a devotee, if you become a devotee, will never fall down. Krishna will give you protection. Krishna says, kauntiya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasya. He will give you protection. Otherwise you are helpless. You can fall down at any moment. But if you take shelter of Krishna, so there are so many facilities for perfection of life. Simply by accepting Krishna, mami kam saranam gaja. If you do not do that, then you are a mura, rascal. Abhajananti manam, ura, manasini, sanma. Param bhavam, how much powerful is Krishna, what he can do for me. Without knowing this, we do not surrender to Krishna. Therefore, it is necessary to assemble like this, to understand Krishna. This Krishna consciousness movement is there all over the world just to help the people to understand real God Krishna. This is the purpose of Krishna consciousness movement. Because people are suffering, they are all murhas, they do not understand Krishna. Or the derived Krishna. Therefore, he will go on suffering. Kanaham disata kuran kipami adasya andhuji. Those who are envious of Krishna, Krishna says, I put them eternally in the hellish condition of life. So if you want to save yourself from the hellish condition of life, you must take to Krishna consciousness and surrender unto him. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.